Okay, so practice Yang style Tai Chi Chuan. First, we have to clear Yang Cheng Fu's 10 principles. Yang Cheng Fu's 10 principles is to guide you how to practice Yang style Tai Chi Chuan. First principle is lift up your head, pushing up slightly. So, this principle in Chinese we call 虚灵顶进. 虚 that means empty, 灵 that means lift up, 顶 means pushing up slightly, 进 that means energy. So first principle is helping you to lift up your head and keep your head straight, not lean side, not lean down. Okay, keep all time straight up. And this principle will be helping you to raise up your spirit. So when we practice Tai Chi Chuan, we always talk about spirit, essence, and qi. So spirit raising up, helping your qi's circulation. Helping your qi circulation, then you get more charging for your inside organ, and you get more essence. More essence, helping you get more spirit. So three things helping each other. But first, you have to, from your inside, you want raise up your spirit. Okay, so this is first principle, what's helpful. The second principle, we're saying it's by shoulder down, elbow down. So we follow the body sequence, talk about the principle. So during practice, you have to keep all time your shoulder sinking down and elbow dropping down. Why? Because our kind of exercise, martial arts, we want our lower body to be heavy, upper body to be light. How can make lower body heavy? Qi sinking down. So during your breathing, you have to keep your qi sinking down. Okay? And how you can help your qi sinking down? Shoulder down, elbow down will be help. Okay? So you don't want to practice always raise up your shoulder. Okay? Let's naturally feel your qi is bring up. So shoulder sinking down, elbow dropping down, then you will be feel qi is sinking down. So this principle, all time we have to keep it. Okay, from inside you feel qi can sinking down. From outside with opponent, when you are shoulder dropping down, elbow dropping down, your opponent is difficult to control your elbow. So here you want your elbow all the time sinking down. Next principle, we talk about your middle body. Okay, so here we see it's by chest sinking in. Okay, so sink your chest. So why we want a chest sink? Because when you are chest raising up, you cannot sinking your qi down. Only when your chest slightly sinking in, then you can feel your qi can sinking down to dantian. And also we think it's by for your back, chest sinking back, how to be rounded. Okay, so when you are back rounded, you naturally feel your spine is being pulling. Okay, so here, chest sinking, naturally your back will be rounded. And from your chest sinking, you also feel your waist, your hip getting relaxing down. Okay, so no way for you to raise up chest, relax your hip. Only when you are chest sinking in, then your hip can relaxing down. So relax your waist is one of the principle. And during the practice, we also required it's by your tailbone tucked in slightly. That's sinking chest, also helpful. Okay, so sinking chest actually is helping your upper body, lower body kind of connect together. Okay, and also when you are sinking chest, you feel your left side, right side also getting connect together. Tai Chi Chuan, we talk about whole body moving exercise. So when you are practice chest sink, okay, actually helping your upper body, lower body, left side, right side getting connect together. Okay, next principle is about energy. Okay, during practice, we think it's by don't use too much force, more use your mind guide your movement goal. Okay, why we don't want to use force? Because you too much force in your arm, okay, tight too much, then become everything is kind of local things. Tai Chi Quan, we think it's by start from soft, okay, from soft, harder, okay. So you don't want start with hard strength too much inside of your one part. When you are too much hard, you cannot from soft to hard. So you don't have enough energy. Only when you are very relaxed by before, you know, your energy can from soft go to the heart. Okay, so this is one of the principle we have to pay attention. Don't use too much strength during the practice, and you have to be relaxed enough. Okay, so during practice, we don't want you to use too much force, but also we don't want you are going to too much limp. Tai Chi Quan is one of the martial arts. Martial arts always talk about the energy. So here you want your inside feel how energy, but not going too tight, not going to the limp. So find the middle way. Okay, so this is about relax. Okay, during practice, also how to pay a little attention is by clear your empty form. First, you have to think about your footwork. Why we want empty form clear? Tai Chi Quan, we talk about yin and yang. Okay, so yin go to yang, yang go to yin, empty go to form, form go to empty. So during practice, you have to clear empty and form. That's helping you what? Helping your body to be flexible. First, you have to clear about your footwork. Each time you make footwork, empty to fall, have to be naturally enough. So from fall to empty, from empty to fall, and clear your footwork. You don't make footwork too big. When you are make too big footwork, each time when you make a transfer footwork, then you cannot clear your empty fall. When you cannot clear empty fall, your moving will be not flexible enough, then you will be held with a double weight time. So we're saying it's by footwork, each time stepping out, how to be naturally enough. That means it's by you can stepping out, you also can naturally pick it up back. Okay, if you are stepping out, you cannot picking back, that means you are empty fall, not clear. You are in double weight time, okay? So empty fall, first, clear from your footwork, and also how to clear in your body movement, arm movement, okay? So each time from empty to fall, from fall to empty, clear, then your body will be flexible, can be flexible enough, okay? Next principle, okay, we talk about it by practice upper body, lower body connect together. Okay, so during practice, not only upper body go, okay, you also have to coordinate with lower body movement. Okay, that means it's by when you each time practice, okay, you have to make lower body with upper body go together. Why? We're saying when you practice Tai Chi Quan, it's a whole body movement. And also, from theories, we understanding where the energy come from. The energy is come from your feet, okay? Explosion by your leg, controlled by your waist, and shown by your hand, okay? So if you don't use energy from your lower body, okay, then you are striking. That's two local things, not whole body things. Tai Chi Quan, we think it's by we start from soft. You need soft to be hard. Okay? That's you need unit your whole body's energy together go to one point. How far make soft to be hard? That means you unit the whole body together. So if you are only do things with upper body movement, that's not strong enough. Only when you are do practice movement with lower body go together, then your energy become to more strength. Okay, so think about energy. It's by always coordinate with lower body movement, not only hand movement. Okay, so this is upper body, lower body go together. And during practice, you also have to pay a lot of attention. It's by keep continued practice. Tai Chi Quan, we have the other name we call long fist. Why we call long fist? That means your energy is continuing the flowing, okay? No stop point, okay? Always, almost, you know, like a water's wave. First wheel, almost to the end, next wave started growing up. The energy is continuing go. So that's why during the practice, we have a lot of circling in our practice, okay? So we don't want your stop, go, go, stop. Okay, keep energy flowing the go. So this is one of the important point. Okay, that's also we call internal martial arts. So because your energy always make a circling to changing direction. We are not from straight, then straight go back. So during practice, how you make movements continuing? You make a little circling, then your energy will be feel more continuing. Make a circling, then you feel continuing go, not straight go and straight back. Okay, so during practice, pay a little attention about this point. Okay, only when your energy flowing the continuing go, you will be have connect feeling. Okay, during practice, you also have to pay a little attention by keep internal, external coordinate together. Tai Chi Quan is one of the internal martial arts. So you want your internal with external movement coordinated together. How? First, understanding movements meaning. Okay, what's mean of this movement? What's the application meaning inside? Then from your inside thinking the movement, okay? Thinking your opponent, then your outside movement can be coordinated together. And when you are inside, outside, coordinated together, then you feel, you know, your spirit is rising up, okay? So don't practice it by outside, do outside, inside, you're thinking anything else, you know, that looks, then it looks like a martial arts, okay? So you have to raise up your spirit and coordinate with outside movement. So understanding each movement's meaning is important. Chinese we say it's by Li Wei Jing Qi Ren Zhi Ti. That means understanding the reason helping you to raising up your spirit, your essence, your qi. Okay, so this is about internal, external coordinated together. One of the principle is by doing practice, you have to keep your mind to be calmed, okay? You know, keep your mind be calmed. That means body is move, but your mind is pretty calmed. Before we were talking about it's by, you know, internal, external, coordinated together. And here we also think it's by, we don't want your mind thinking too much lot of things, because when you are thinking too much, like you're thinking too much, you know, today I'm doing what, then you are not focusing by the movement, okay? And we want your mind to be calmed, because you are kind of concentrate is by what's your opponent doing, especially when we later to doing the push hands, you know, all people have experience with the push hands, we know we don't thinking guess opponent doing next is what. Only when your opponent start to doing something, then you from your contact with your opponent, your inside start know what your opponent going to do, then you are naturally responding your opponent. So we don't, you know, first thinking what my opponent doing and what my opponent going to, guessing your opponent, that's your mind is not calmed enough. And probably you're always late than your opponent. So from Tai Chi theory, we know it's by 太极拳 we want you move late, arrive first. Let your opponent move first. Until you understand your opponent, what your opponent wants to do, then you start move. So keep your mind to be calmed. This is kind of important. So those is about 10 principles. Next, we talk a little bit about our hand technique and footwork. Hand technique in Yang style is kind of easy, okay? We only have three different hand technique. One we call palm, one we call hook, one we call fist. How we make palm? Palm, we requirement is by you have to extend your fingers slightly, okay? And keep your fingers bend slightly. And between fingers, have slightly space, okay? And the thumb, how to more open, because you want your tiger mouth opened enough. Don't go too tight, okay? Don't go to all time close. Different martial arts requirement is different. So also don't go too much length, okay? So here, extend it from inside slightly, okay? And fingers bend slightly. Later, all different palm, you know, different using of the palm, they are same shape, okay? Like when you do the striking, you turn slightly side. You do the push, you are more front. You do the straight palm, you also keep same palm shape, okay? And when you do the grabbing, same thing, word of up, same palm shape, okay? So this is about palm. Fist, how we make a fist? We require fist is like this, okay? So here, close your fingers, bend your four fingers in, and thumb outside these two fingers. You have to make a four fist, don't make empty fist, okay? Four enough, but not going too tight. And front of your fist, how to be flat enough, okay? Where is the fist point? Normally we say it's by front of your fist, it's energy point. Sometimes we use back of your fist, okay? So these two points, it's where the energy point in fist, okay? So no matter which energy point, we always it's make same shape of the fist, but sitting we could different. Sometimes we bend in, sometimes we straight, okay? Sometimes we chop outside, okay? But how you make a fist always is the same. Hook here, how we make a hook, we think it's by wrist bend down, fingertips close together, okay? This is how we make a hook, kind of easy. So Yang style, we see movements big, large. So our hook also is kind of big, large. Don't make small hook. So here, wrist bend down enough, okay? So when you use hook, we think energy point is in back of your palm, okay? So from here, use backside, strike to your opponent. Striking to where? Normally, we think it's by striking to opponent's throat and your opponent's middle body, okay? So this is the energy point of the hook. Those is about the hand technique. Footwork, two main steps, okay? So first, we talk about the bow step. What's the bow step requirement? First, we think it's by toe direction. One toe direction point to 45 degree to corner direction. The other one how to be straight forward, okay? And in here, you have to clear it by both step. Front leg how to bend, and the knee don't go over your toe. Back leg how to be straight, but straight without lock. We think it's by naturally straight. And also clear is by between your feet, you have to keep around shoulder width part space, okay? We want shoulder width part space because helping you pushing forward, supporting back, and crouch rounded, supporting your left and right. Don't make too narrow, okay? Wide enough. So this is about bow step. Empty footwork. Empty footwork, toe direction basically same as bow step. Also, it's one in corner, 45 degree. The other, straight forward. We have two kind of empty footwork. One, touching with the heel. One, touching with the ball of your foot. So what's the requirement? Similar as bow step, knee, toe in the line, okay? And the toe direction straight. Difference is by, you can see from here, more weight in back leg, less weight in front leg. That's what we call empty footwork, okay? And when you are make empty footwork, you have to clear its back. We don't have shoulder width part space, okay? It's a center line to side. Don't cross footwork, okay? So center line to side, and don't go too wide. When you are touching with the heel, your front leg is more straight. When you are touching with the ball of your foot, your knee is bent slightly. So this is footwork. And we also have some footwork. Stand with one leg movement. When you are picking up your leg, upper leg high enough, fore leg bend in, toe point down. Standing leg have to be naturally straight. Direction similar as before, one to corner, knee direction point straight, okay? And pull step from here, based on the bow step, right toe open to corner, knee follow toe direction bend, and front leg naturally straight from here, sinking down, toe direction one in corner, one in straight. So this is a pull step. Those is Yang style footwork.